YouTube fam, happy holidays. I hope you've been enjoying yourself, eating good food, hanging out with family, and taking time to reset your batteries. All right. Personally, I've been trying to do that. I've succeeded maybe 25% of the time. As is still evidenced by my inability to stay up until 10 p.m. Knocked out like an old lady. But anyway, I have spent a little bit of time, I got banned from actually like doing any trades or anything, but I spent a little bit of time trying to catch up and learn from the ICT vids. So I want to do some back testing on what I've learned so far, and it still jives with my process for finding the trades I'm looking for, but it helps exponentially on entry, which is the part that I've been having so many issues with. So let's dive in and see what's up. Okay, it's like what, 6:57 a.m. Kitty is playing with his wrapping, because why give the cat actual presents, because they don't care. Anyway, I have no concept of how long this is going to take. I'm probably going to do it a couple of times. I'm going to make annotations, I'm going to take screenshots so I can like study it later. And just start building that kind of like documentation so I can see what I did right, wrong each time I did this. If that sounds like a good time, hit the like button, subscribe, drop a comment down and tell me what your favorite Christmas dish was, because what was mine? I'm going to say ham. There was some delicious ham, some yummy fat. Oh, I love fat. You're learning so much about me. Anyway. I'm going to make myself patty. All right, cool. You know, fun fact, I'm trying to decide. I feel like it's a good plan to focus on one or two pairs. So you've seen me focus on Bitcoin or Ethereum. And I've been primarily focused on Ethereum recently. Ooh, hi, Kitty. Kitty's going up the stairs. And I'm thinking maybe I want to add like a Forex pair to that. And I think I mentioned this before. So I'm going to do a bunch of paper trading on a particular Forex pair and see how that works. And I'll continue my real trading on the crypto stuff in the meantime. Why? Paper trading on the Forex pair, because I've never really done it. So I still need to test out and make sure everything works. And then two, this gives me time to understand the whole concept of pips and how much it costs, check out a proper broker and see what the spreads are and blah, blah, and then figure out if that's what I really want to do. All right, cool. So we have Bitcoin on the daily. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a top-down analysis. And just for funsies, I'm going to pop open my notepad and drop, again, my notes in here for what I'm looking for. And this is probably going to change a little bit. All right. So let's get our text, our handy text. And we're going to drop it in here. And okay, we're going to swing that. So just to recap, right? So we're going to, of course, each day check the news, mainly because I just want to make sure if there's anything that's going to like affect the trades, right? So, and then we're doing a high time frame analysis. So I like looking at the weekly candle and see how it's forming. It's coming in tiny but red. And I mean, we already know the overall bias is bearish, right? So understanding that, I've decided that for the most part, unless it gives me something different, like for example, we've got this big fair value gap right here that they've eaten about half of it. Approximately, you know, like I would think perhaps they might want to like come eat the rest of it before they continue on coming down. And we can see they've sort of done something similar like here. They came up into it a lot more aggressively, almost ate all of it and then sold off from it. Anyway, so that's all I'm going to do on that one. And then from a daily perspective, well, this has been pretty lame for the Christmas period here. So I didn't feel any need to do any trading in here. Nothing exciting. So what we're going to do is, let's grab this guy. I'm gonna hit a replay button and we're just gonna like close our eyes and do that Stevie Wonder thing and then just be like, all right, where did that take us? Okay, Tuesday, September 6th. Okay, perfect. All right, so we're bearish. Price is coming around. We have this fair value gap. Areas that I think price might come down to for funsies. I'm gonna drop this as a target. And what else do we have that we can pay attention to? So I'm just doing the bare minimum on the daily. So what do you, yep, that corresponds. There's that down here again, 59.57. So I'll drop that as a potential second target. But in the meantime, that seems to be where we're coming down to. All right. And in terms of fair value gaps on the daily, I'm just gonna mark out this guy. That's what's left of this FVG or imbalance. Oops. That. And let's just put that in there. All right. And we haven't really come up into it very much, and we've dropped and eaten this liquidity here. And we're coming, we made almost equal lows equals down here. So we could be aiming to come down even lower. So I'm gonna go into the 1 hour now. All right. And beautiful. So on the 1 hour, we've got a fair value gap to pay attention to. Lovely. And all right, so first things first. So besides the news, all that good stuff. What day is this? September 7 p.m. Okay. Let's see how the day's been trailing along. So this is the sixth. Let's see what was midnight. So this is the opening candle. So I'm just gonna do this since we're over here. Gonna do that. And then I'm gonna just this way I know what the opening price is at the opening price at midnight, at the start of the day. And looks like we traded above it. Where was it at 8:30? It was a little bit above. Okay. And then we dropped off quite considerably at, all right, so at what looks like to be 2, 1 o'clock. Just dropped. Let's drop down to the 15 minutes and see. So what I'm thinking about is, and what I'm learning is, like from the opening price, right? Depending on which is lower, the midnight opening or 8:30, approximately. So we'd use this guy. So this is kind of like we opened, we traded above it, and then we came back into it. So if I'm looking for shorts, what I'm learning is if I'm looking for a short and I'm looking for price to go up higher first, and in this case it had these fair value gaps to go eat from the previous day, and this is like an intermediary high because it formed a fair value gap and price came to rebalance it. Learning so much about how the candles form and all that good stuff. So let's zoom in on this puppy and see what we could have seen. So price rallied away from the opening price, which, you know, for me says great, eat some of this and then come back down. In terms of like liquidity hunts though, it looks like they came to eat this stuff. This guy was the last of that, and then we started forming these short-term well, these other intermediary highs right there, and then there's another intermediary high right here, and they came back into it. But none of these are higher than the others. 1, 2, 3. So that was, you know, giving me a good idea that we're going to continue on down from here. So, and this is just my way. So, like after 8:30, all right, so we saw this. 30, we'll probably wait till about 10 o'clock, right? So price rallied back down to the opening price. Whoops. And then It rolled back up again and it's still made another short-term high here. But that tells me that we're continuing down. So most likely we can let me just kind of come back over here just for funsies, just so we could see how this looks on the lower time frame, right? So I made this little tiny fair value gap. Let's go on to the 5 minutes on that to see what that looks like. So, price did all of this fun stuff, and actually you could have taken the short from, here where it's this fair value gap from price roll back into it. And then had your stop loss right above here is what I would be thinking. But if you miss that, then you're looking, and of course you're looking for a break, which basically occurred here. So let's do a little annotation a little bit just so we can see what we're thinking. And since we missed all of this, like this was like or FEG right here, right? And I'm just gonna mark them out just so I know. And then we had our break. We had a nice little break in this general vicinity. Whoops. Come on. Right, and I think I have something for a break right here. Just playing. We had a break here, and then I mean we had the fair value gap, but then technically I think this would be considered the in this general vicinity would be considered the order block technically. So you could set your entry right here and then down she goes in the hopes that they'll they could always come back and eat it if they want to and then continue. But so far, based on the way things have been forming, we had our liquidity run, eaten. I mean, technically, everything along this line could be considered a stop hunt because that's where all of the shorting, the short stops were hanging out, for folks who were going short. And then, of course, they came and ate all of this fair value gap. Good for them. This one up here didn't seem very important to take, I think. It was too small, but they came in and ate almost all of those. And then we formed this intermediary high right here. And then another one here. This is a, I feel like that's another one because it formed another, well, I guess it could be a short-term high. And then this short-term high, and then it broke. So then you could have set your stop loss over here if you've taken it from here. And then let's zoom in. Would that order have been filled? Because I'm finding that setting it at the body, right, is what you want. And then you would have been filled on this candle. You would have seen a little bit of drawdown, but it wouldn't have been too bad. All right, so let's see what other opportunities we had. We had this break right here as well with this fair value gap right here. So technically, this manipulation, it's another area where the stops were hunted right here. So that's a bad plan, right? So then if you'd chosen and made this fair value gap, this entry would have been a lot rough, but then your stop loss would be above here, and then you would have taken an even bigger drawdown. I like this one, but it all depends on when you get in here, right? And then let's look. So we have another option, this general vicinity right here. So I like this one, a strong break below this area. So let's bring that in. Can't draw. Don't judge me. Okay, so we have this break right here, and then we have this fair value gap. So I would be looking, along with the same principles, right? So we formed, we have this intermediary high, we have the fair value gap here, and then we formed a lower high, still telling me price is continuing to go down, right? And then we have these almost relatively equal lows here, which can draw the price lower. And then we have areas below here that we can use as targets, right? So, and even more than that, we'll go back into the 15-minute for targeting, right? So, break happened about here, depending on how you want to draw it. Fair value gap. So, this has already occurred. This guy's come in here. So, we have two options for potential entry. You could set two different limit orders to see which one gets picked up. And this is coming back up. I personally would want this one right here, and I'll put my thing above here. And then let's go down to the 15 minute and let's see where our targets are. Because, my bad. We didn't, whoops, that's cheating. So we know it's coming all the way down there, my bad. But we'd set this 17 something down here, but we have other targets to look for as well. So I wanted to give myself other targets to play with. So sorry about that. Now we know too much about where this goes, but it's all about the setup for the moment. So a little cheating there, my bad. So I just wanted to, so we're here and am I crazy or is my stuff just disappearing? Oh, it's all the way down here. Okay, that's a far away target. Let's see. Here's an even closer one as a target. That's that low here. I wanted to see if. Okay, so there's this one right here as well. So there's this low, 19, 6, 17. That guy. So let me do this. And that one's already too close, so not that one. So let's, this is from the daily, so let's see if we can aim for that puppy. Right. So that's pretty far, huh? Right. So let's go into the 5 minutes again. All right, this is coming back up. So I have one of two choices, right? I have this fair value gap, which means I could come in here. So I have this potential limit order. And let's drag her down. All right. And then we have this potential, that one, same stop loss. A little bit higher, but a little bit lower entry. All right. And let's go down into the let's say 3 minutes if it'll let us. Okay, so on the 3 minute, so this would be right at the body of this guy. Let's see. All right, and let's move this forward. Okay, so we would get the lower entry. Okay, so we get both entries. So this guy, so if they want to rebalance all of that. All right, so we have two orders in for this short, either here or here. Okay, all right, cool. And now we see that we would have gotten a lot of that, but we didn't get a chance to really focus on. I just dragged it down a bit. So we would have gotten that lickety split. Let's go into the 1 hour, right? Because the real target is this guy down here. So let's go back to our 15 minute. So we're sort of cheating because we already know it does that, but we have a target. So let's see if we can get to our target for both of these, right? Now, the beauty about the way this thing is set up, right? And I'm trying to figure out if I'm aiming for this guy or this guy if I have both of them, right? Okay. So these are, and that's a 1 to 10, 1 to 14. Okay. So let's see how this is forming, right? So on the 5 minute, we haven't, this is what's wrong with the replay thing sometimes, y'all. Okay, so we have an insane drop, right? What does it do? Does it continue down? Let's see. And there's some turning around a little. Cause that's pretty egregious. And just for funsies, like how far is that? It's a 5 to 9, right? That's pretty juicy. All right. Now, does this give us an opportunity? And let's be honest, like with this big of a pull, I probably would move my stop loss into profit, you know, but we gotta wait. So we're still going down. Okay, let's see what it forms. Okay. Now this is a lot. 1 to 14, this would have been like 1 to 9.5. Let's see, do we get it? Because I'm aiming for my being. This would, you know, because this is what? 1 to 8. I mean, what do you guys think? Am I being greedy on this in this moment right here? But let's see. We've eaten all this liquidity. We haven't formed any. The other thing to note is the way these green candles are forming. None of them have been violated to the top side. They've all been, you know, boom. Let's see this one. All right, let's continue. All right. So now I might exit my position right here. And what would I have gotten? 1 to 6. It might be the wrong move, or maybe I don't exit my position and wait for it to do something. Let's see. So we've made, this is like, if I draw this over, and we're still hoping for this, right? So this is 1 to 6, 3. Approximately. And this green candle, but we've made one higher. It's been violated. So I would exit here and take my profits, at least for this one. And then let's move our stop loss for the other one. Let's see. Nope. Lower. Move it to here for the other one and see. What happens? Probably will get stopped out, but I want my potential to continue on down. Take my profits, and now we're meandering about. Now, take this profit, leave that one open, move the stop loss here so I can get at least, you know, double. So let's see. All right, we're thinking. All right, because this is a short-term high, so that's why I picked that. This is another short-term high. Intermediary, actually, with the imbalance that's been thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and move my stop loss to this guy above that guy again. So I'm bearish, right? So I'm thinking it's gonna continue down. All right, here we go. All right. All right. Okay. Haven't closed above, so we're still good. And ooh, almost. Oof. I wonder if I should be like, okay, so for this guy, here's another intermediary. I move my stop loss to above here now. So close, coming to rebalance. All right, so this might come up. Let's see. Yep. And I'm stopped out right there. So close. Maybe I should make it just a little bit above the target and then I would have gotten it right there. What do you guys think? That's not a bad plan, right? So if I go with where I got stopped out, that's a 1 to 11.8, yo, not bad, right? So that's a 1 to 11.8 and a what's the other one? Let's do this. And then the other one is a 1 to 6.33. So if we do a little calculus, don't know what fees are. So if I'm using, let's say, I have $1,000 because eventually I want to get there, right? Because I did some calculations about that. Let's say I have $1,000 and I want to risk 1% each of my $1,000. So what's that? $10? Think that's $10. Let me grab my trusty calculator because I don't trust my brain. Don't tell anybody. Okay, so let's say I have $1,000, right? And I want to risk exactly 0.1%. Oh, well, that's $100, actually. Let's see what. 1,000 times. That can't be right. That's 10%. Yeah, so it would be $10, 0.01. $10, right? So 1% is $10. And so if I made, so that's $10 times 6.33. So that's going to be like what? $63.30 approximately. 10 times 6.33. Yeah. And then $10 times, what was this thing? 11.18. 11.18. 10 times 11.18. Oops. 10 times 11.18. Oh, so that would be 111.8. Okay, not bad. And now my balance has become plus 63.3. These calculators these days are just the worst, man. Plus $1,000. So that's now I have 1175.1. All right, cool. All right, balance increased. Cool, awesome. So let's say I started with $1,000. How long did that take? If I, had these two orders in, let's see. First order, we stopped out 4 hours and 50 minutes. Okay, not bad. The first one, when I got a little scared, took 1 hour and 40. All right, cool. I left them both open, watched how it progressed, did the same thing. Yeah, I think maybe for, but let's see, does it actually get to my actual take profit? It probably does, but there's this imbalance up here they might want to like mess with. Now, do we see another opportunity, right? So this might be okay for me for this day. That's a good $175 for the day on my $1,000. Cool. Let's come back tomorrow. Awesome. Oh, and I learned something. I learned something. Let's back this up a smidge to here. To here. Let's back this up. So I learned something on the replay button, and you can actually see it. So, let's zoom back in just for funsies, so you can see, right? So we have the two orders. So like I can let this run. Let's do 3 minutes. Oh, come on, not far enough. Just for the funsies, so we can see like the dollar values like come back. So we came here. So the first one we're looking for an order here, and the second one here. So then let's do this, do da 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 da. And then I would just hit sell, and I'm in. And then come back up, da 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 da. Okay, I would hit sell. So I have two of them in there. Beautiful. And then I could. No. What am I doing? That's not what I wanted. Oh, that's to read. That's to adjust. My bad. That's shouldn't be there. Anyway. Okay. And then we could just let it play. Oops. What is going on? That's fine. And then we could just let it play. And have fun. Somehow I was still in the back button. So let's try that again. I just like seeing it. We'll just sell there. And then I won't mess with the other button. And then sell there. And then let's go to the 15 minute and let's press play. Now this is a different value for this, right? Not $1,000, but it's nice to look at. You know? And then this is where I would flatten. I guess I can't pick which one I flatten. Let's do that. And then it's too far. It does dry back up. And that's where we start to get close to our thing right there, and then flatten. And then that would have been, I think this is on 100,000 actually. But cool, right? I like that. It's a pity I can't like set the, you know, adjust the settings for this, but it's whatever. All right. Let's see, how long have we been doing this? 30 minutes? All right, let's go grab Ethereum and see if we can do a similar scenario. Okay, and we'll just do the calculation. So let's go here. Let's grab ETH, and then let's do the 1 day, and let's drop that. Come on, let's clear up everything. And this is without anything. So primary purpose. So this is Ethereum. We are still very flat and sideways. Boring. So let's grab a replay button. Let's do our Stevie Wonder thing, and then let's click. Okay. All right, so looks like, you know, I mean, the main thing is bearish. Looks like we've had like a bit of a bullish run, but we've just had a break of that, and we're coming to rebalance this. So I am still very bearish. So let me do this. Let's do this as our imbalance to be played with on the upper level. And in terms of liquidity, that needs to be eaten. This guy down here. So I'm looking for some sell side. There's all of this. So potential area for me to focus on as a target. Approximately. Might just be this imbalance right here. So let me just see what's left of it as a potential target. Okay, so overall bearish. We've done a bit of a retracement to eat all of this. And we've not crossed this short-term high. We've eaten the liquidity up here. So this is buy side gone. We have this short-term. Unless it passes this thing and continues up, then I think then it'll convince me. Problem though is we've gotten a nice break right here on the daily, so we might be just coming in to eat this to continue on down. So let us see. All right, so in terms of liquidity, like buy side liquidity up here, I mean, if for folks who went short, it's probably above this short term high right here. Do I think they're going to come all the way back up there on the daily? Maybe not. I don't know. Let's see. What can we see? All right. So this is where we're at. Okay. Let's take the auto off. All right. So let's be a little bit more accurate on this. That's been eaten. So we can adjust this to there. Perfect. It'll be a little bit more clear. Let's bring this over. Smidgy smidge within range here and adjust it upwards. Okay. All right. So, I don't know when we are. All right. So, first things first, what day is it? It is August 22nd, 7 p.m. All right. So, I want to push to the 26th so I can have like a fresh day's worth to play with. So, I want to see the 26th to come into being. Where's midnight? Okay. So the close of this candle is going to be our open. And opening price. Okay. So that's the six. So now I, that's one. There it is. Sorry about that. It's opening price right there. So now I want to push, because I wouldn't be awake in the middle of the night. So I'm going to push price up to 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, when I would be awake and have a potential for entering some sort of trade. So if I'm expecting price to come back down, then I want it to eat this buy side liquidity right here. Approximately that guy. Could be this guy. So I could anchor it here and see they could tap above. But let's see, right? I want them to come up here, eat that for me to come back down and like aim for this guy really down here. All right, so let's see what they do. Right. Okay, so do 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 do. Surprise, came back up. A lot of manipulation there. This is at what time? Oh, sorry guys, went too far. It's 10 a.m. It's midnight. My bad. Let's back up a bit because I just need to understand. Should be down on the 15-minute doing this push forward. 15, 5, 15. Okay, so let's move it this way. So I want to see what 8:30 is. 6:30. 7. 7:30. 8:15, 8:30. Okay. So this is the lowest opening price. I'm gonna pay attention to this guy instead of this guy. So whichever one's the lowest is the one I pay attention to. Okay. All right, so if price is gonna continue lower, I want it to ride above this and then continue on down. If I don't see what I'm looking for, then I don't, there's no trade, right? All right, so prices rallied above. We've got this break right here coming in. We had another break right here. Oh, I didn't make my notes. 9 o'clock. So we're coming in 9:15. Okay, 9:30. So here's the rally above. We've eaten some short stops here. Okay. Let's see. Okay, so 9:45. Okay, so 10 o'clock. All right, so let's see what we see. All right, so we had this break, we've rallied above it, and we've eaten some liquidity here. I'm looking for a buy side. They may not come all the way up here. So what do we get? And we might not get something I can trade. Okay. So let's go down into the 5 minute. All right. So we've eaten some liquidity here. And on the 5 minute, we've made a short-term high. There's a tiny imbalance right there. And this is an intermediary high because it had the imbalances. We've eaten it up. Now I'm looking for some sort of break, to tell me I can do stuff. Okay, so we have a break here, and we have this imbalance right here for the break. It's not the best break. It is a break. Okay, let's do this. I know I'm slightly cheating because I have some concept, but all right. And we have this one, this fair value gap. So this turns this whole thing into an intermediary high so that I can set my order here. And it's in and around. We've traded above the opening price, which I think, and now I'm looking for it to go lower. So now we do this above that guy. And now I would set my take profit to somewhere just a little bit into here. Maybe that's just the top of it. Now let's be a little bit more ambitious, right? Let's try and eat this, see if we can get most of this. Let's go about midway through. What is that? 3.72? Okay. Let's see. And we have this sell side liquidity, so I might let's do a little bit above that instead. Let's try for that six. All right, so let's see what happens. Do I get my order? No. Looks like I don't get my order. So actually, I do get my order filled. Hold on, let's zoom in. Just barely, look at that. Isn't that crazy? Because I wanted it at the close of that can. I just barely got it filled. Okay. So I'm in. It's crazy. Maybe I have other opportunities to enter again. So let's continue on down. Okay. And at this point, we've got all these fair value gaps coming in. So we're coming down. Now, the only concern I have here is if price wants to turn around, like it fuels it. But I'm bearish, right? And we had this big break on the daily, so we should be turning around, right? So hold on. All right. So now we had this break here. Price didn't come back into it. We have this break here, right? So a potential for another short, probably from here. I don't know if they want to eat the whole thing. So let's do that. Yeah, let's see. Can we get it from here, maybe? And we set it above this little level and then continue on down. It's a smaller contract. Let's say this is the biggest one. This has a little bit smaller. Do we get it? Because technically I should have put it here, right? Or like midway through here, you know? But let's leave it where it is for now and see if price comes back up. So no. Okay, so lesson learned. It should be this guy, or at least midway through it for an entry. So that one's dead. We didn't get that. So now we're continuing down. Let's see if we get another potential. Here's a nice break, fair value gap. Let's see if I can get another entry. It's right there. Put this right there and continue on down. And having learned that things might want to stop a little bit away from it, let's do that. Okay, and that'd be a 1 to 7. Let's see. Do we get it to come back up? Think about it. All right, we do. It ate that. We're gonna see here. So we've gotten this short-term high. Let's see if they get it gets violated. So I'm looking for it to create another intermediary high, which is what's up here, which is why I put my stop loss up there. Let's see. Okay. So we've made a, let's see. Just consolidating. Okay. Eating that liquidity. We haven't violated this thing down here, so we might be going back up. Now, if I'm being honest, I would probably be moving my stop loss or setting my stop loss to a specific area. At this point, I would have put my stop loss to break even, probably about here. A little bit above that. And then I'll just move it as it's creating new situations. But we're still in this one. We've got two. And I'm very bearish, so I'm expecting price to continue downward, but it's thinking. All right, so we've tapped into this imbalance. Beautiful. I'm gonna move my bigger stop loss to the top of this thing right here for this guy, protecting that. And let's continue on down. Okay, now another potential entry. We've got a nice break here in balance. I could add in some more. Already tapped that guy, so probably gonna leave it alone, but let's see. So now we're in the imbalance and we're thinking. Okay, I'm just gonna let this play out, right? Okay. Now, meandering about this guy, we've made another structure here. So I don't know how far into this profit taking we are at the moment, but trying to protect my interests. We're inside of this thing here. We've made an intermediary low. Right. So at this point, I would be moving my stop loss for this one above this guy. Still give it room to breathe and leave the other one as is. Right. And let price unfold. Now, this feels like it's trying to turn around a bit, right? Because it's eaten all this liquidity. Do I see something for it to turn around? A little bit of a break, right? It's an intermediary low. It's been eaten. We're up here. So, at this point, I might feel the need to. The big boy is how far in, right? We're about what? Halfway to what we're looking for. So this would be 18%, 9% move. That's a lot, right? 14 hours. All right, so I'm here, right? And let's do a little measuring with this tool, right? So if we get stopped out, that's 1.89. If we take this, it's 1 to 3. If we set it to here, it's 1 to 4. If we set it to where we want it to be, it's here. This guy is 1 to 2, right? So, I mean, I feel like all stop losses should be moved, right? But let's leave it alone for the moment. We are. For this very cheeky entry, we are, that's 4% move. It's not bad, right? And we're 9 hours in. So we've made another structure here. So let's move all stop losses to here. Now we might get stopped out. We might not. Price might want to. Because I'm worried the imbalance might, bring us back up. But the question is, we have this short-term high. If it violates that, I'll consider closing. So let's continue. Okay, beautiful. So now we're continuing down. Lovely. So we made this little intermediary high with the imbalance. That's why it's an intermediary high, so I can move my stop loss again. Probably I won't, but we're still coming to eat, coming down to eat all of this. All right, so we're thinking, so all this liquidity's been eaten again. It's eating the imbalance. We made another area here. Okay, so now it's been violated, right? This one has, so we've made another one. So we're a little higher than that. Let's see how it closes. Okay. Right, so if we come above here, we might be turning around. Let's see. All right, so we've made short-term high right here. Okay, so All stop losses have been moved into profit. So we'll just have to, position has been, zoom in, has been, we probably will get stopped out here. Should we? Yep. And I, let's see here. Probably, let's see. So we have all this liquidity eaten. We'll have a break right here. They haven't come back to eat all of this, but they've been coiling back upward on the 5 minutes. So let's see how far they want to coil. I'm in decent profit for both of these. We're just meandering along. Okay. We've broken that. Liquidity eaten. So we have a little bit of a break here. Coming back to eat that. Let's see. Do we continue down after that? Okay. So we're just thinking about what we want to do. Okay, so now I'm pretty sure we're continuing on down. Nice juicy break right here. Maybe it's lying to me, I don't know. On, we got all that liquidity below. We're bearished. There we go. There you go. So my stop loss was not violated. Yes. Cool. So now we are continuing on. That is taking a while, y'all. Can I just say a while? So let's continue along. All right, so now we've busted down. So I'm expecting them. Okay, so there's another. So we have other opportunities to move our stop loss into better, more advantageous locations. So right now we have the short-term high. We haven't gotten above here, and we have this break right here. We had a tiny bit, but we've moved above it. So let's see if we're gonna get an intermediary. Okay. Okay. Let's give me what I'm looking for. So a bit of an they came eat that, whatever, still not worried about it. Okay. So we have this break. They're coming in to eat that. Ate it. Okay. All right, so now we have a better break here. They'll probably come back up and eat this one, maybe that one, and then continue on down if we're lucky. Right, now that's pretty decisive. You want to eat that. That's a nice break coming in that direction. All right, so we're meandering about inside of this thing. We've just seen this. That's be a 1 to 4. And this is gonna be a 3.5. Because we're up here at 1490, and my stop loss is here. I am still leaving it as is. I don't have the structure I need to continue, so I'll leave it as is. Okay. Because we might be making a proper intermediary high right here, and that'd be a place I can move my stop into if I see what I'm looking for in here. So, coming in to eat some of that. All right, we got relatively equal highs here. Okay, so now, beautiful. We have a break right here. Potential for another re-entry if you wanted it to continue on further down. We've got this nice piece. What I need to see is it break this thing below. Let's see. Looks like it wants to continue on higher. We've got this short-term low. Have we broken above yet? No, eco highs. Now we've broken above it. Coming in to eat all of this liquidity right here. Let's see. All right. Okay, not really a break. Now we have a break. And we have this intermediary high. And then now we have different structure, intermediary high, and another one right here. So let's see what happens, then I can move my stop loss again. So we should be continuing down lower now. Not a break, cool. Let's wait for it to break below here, and then we can move the stop loss. Okay, we're still thinking, eating that, coming back down, beautiful. All right, doing a lot of consolidating. Okay. Now, the only way, if it invalidates this guy, then I'll probably close big one so I can lock in more of that profit. But we have a bit of a break in structure right here. It ate the rest of that imbalance right there. And then let's see. Continue on down. So now I'm just managing the existing trade, right? And we're just, made this guy. Okay. Coming up again. This is why I don't move my stop loss until I see a proper structure. Because then I could get stopped out. All right, so now we have another intermediary high. This one right here, beautiful. I'm going to move, now is when I'm going to think about moving my stop loss for both of them to about here. I know it's coiling up. We've just got a nice break. So I'm going to see if I can enter again right here at a third small position just for funsies. At the base of this guy and put it above this because I'm not expecting price to go above that again. And then let's continue on down to this guy. All right, let's see how that plays out. Looks like I get an entry. Okay, we've made a lower thing from here. Did I get my entry? No, did not get it. Was that exactly at the base of this thing? Still wouldn't have gotten it. Entry should have been at the opening of this candle, like whenever price got back to that. But didn't get it, therefore. Nope, look for a different opportunity. All right, beautiful. So here's another opportunity. Nice break. I'm going to try for an entry right here. I'm going to put it above this intermediary high because I don't expect it to come back up. And I'm moving all my stop losses to right above here. Okay. And then we'll continue on down. Let's see. Did we get it? Looks like we got it. And that looks like I'm stopped out right there. See? Yep. Stopped out. So that's a big fat X on that one. Okay. Not the best entry. Oops, come on, coiling up. So am I about to be, and now I'm stopped out altogether. All right, let's see what I got. I was playing with fire on that one, I will admit. All right, so If we got stopped out for this first one right here, 2.54, and then this one. Three point 5 2. Okay, so on our $1,000 account, let's grab our text. So on our new value, which was 1,075.1. Oops, can't type, y'all. And risking 1%. Of that, which I believe is times 0.1, 11, which is 11.751. So we made 11.751 times, what's that? Let's move this to the side. Times 2.54, 2.54. Times 2.54. So 29.85. I'll just round up. 29.85 on that one, and then 11.7751. Times 3.52. 3.52. So 11.751 times 3.52. 41.36. So that's what we made on that one. And what did we lose? 11.71. On that one loss. Oops. Let's come over here and we got stopped out. 0.73. Okay. Times 0.73. Okay, 11.7751 times 0.73. $8.57. Negative 8.58. So that makes a grand total on that trade. So 41.36 minus 20. Oh, I'm just 29.85. So 62.63. 62.63 total. Okay, so now I've upped my balance from 11.75.1 plus 62.63. And I will just stop for the day. So new balance and go take a nap. Come back the next day. And I'll just continue growing it like that. 12.37.73. And then that'll be my new balance. And then I'll have a new 1% I can risk. Isn't that beautiful? All right. I feel like it's time for me to go work out. And the sunlight has finally started showing. It's 8 o'clock. We've been on here for an hour, so that's a lot of me for you to deal with. But I'm liking what I'm seeing so far with what I'm looking for. As long as I see what I'm seeing, trust it. I got stopped out on that last one, trying to roll in on what is essentially a ranging market's not a good plan. So that's fine. I'll take my lumps where I get them. So that's how I'm going to be trading moving forward on my account. All right, guys. I'm at like $8.01, $8.1 USDT left in their account. So no real good wins so far. So I'm gonna use this model and just go with it. All right, let me know your thoughts in the comments. Don't forget to drop a comment about your favorite holiday dish. If you don't celebrate Christmas and stuff like that, just tell me what you like to do during this time off, you know? And happy Hanukkah to all the other folks too. And for everybody else, just happy having time off, you know? All right, cool. And drop a like, subscribe if you like it, and definitely drop a comment because I'm definitely interested in seeing it. All right, so that's it for now. I will be probably doing these. I'm still off and still relaxing, so I won't be doing these like consistently. But you know, I'm still trying to relax myself and enjoy the vacation time. But I was dreaming about it and I was having a real itch to practice what I'm learning from ICT. I'm gonna be adding him to my list of folks as the top person that I'm following. But remember, Meet Kaplan, he explains things in a much simpler way. ICT goes deep into the details. And honestly, I need the details because with the details, it helps me understand is price going to turn around? Just like the reason I didn't, you know, I've been making adjustments to the trades as it's been forming, right? Those are the things that I'm practicing. I'm going to continue to practice and get better and be able to spot it and all that good stuff. All right, guys. Happy, crap, it's Thursday. Dang it, my holiday is coming to a close. I still have a few days, but all right. Happy, Thursday. I hope you're also off and enjoying yourselves. If you are not, well, still find your joy and peace. Okay? Shakira.